Joey Tattoo and the producers of Tattoo Rescue. This is Monster Monkey Studios on a typical Friday night. My name is Rain Lynn, and I'm here with our counterperson Katie, the sister of my husband Bosco.
We do all custom work here. We have no flash in the building. Everything is drawn for each and every customer.
As you can see, it's a little bit cramped here with not really very many people in the lobby. We opened with the concept of different rooms for each artist and a private room for each tattoo.
Hi, I'm Sean Amley. I do all the machine maintenance in the shop. Pretty much any kind of tattooing that comes through the door.
Moving on, this is my husband's tattoo space, conveniently located across from mine. Alright, moving down the hallway. You can see that, this is my tattoo space, and you can see that we've installed these pocket doors. We built every wall in this place when we first opened. We were on a strict budget, but we made it work with the private room model, which is kind of a feat for a startup business. Over here, I've got my bric-a-brac, my knickknacks, things for clients to look at. Most of it I'm not really too jazzed about. A lot of it was given to us by clients, so there isn't really a cohesive theme, which is something that I would like to change in the future. The only thing that needs to stay in here is my Nana pillow. So what we have here is one of our more interesting projects. We've been at this for about 2 years now. This, as far as I know, is the most detailed, most continuous pair of fishnet stocking tattoos that the world has ever seen. As you can see, there's a continuous lace pattern that goes around the inner thigh. Bob, go ahead and turn around for us. There you see the back seams, which is what we originally started with before the fishnets were added. All right, let's move on and take a look at the back of the shop. You can see here that this, we were told, is a structural wall and needed to stay, but it really put a cramp in our style when designing the spaces. So it kind of makes the flow a little less than optimal for what we do. In the back here is actually two stations that's been turned into one with a door and storage. You would have to go through one station in order to get to another. This is Sean's space. Unfortunately, he has to be here in the back, so anything going on in the front, he really never knows about unless we come back and tell him. He likes to use larger chairs and equipment, but especially being so tall, it's hard for him to even fit back here effectively. All right, we're gonna take a look at the bathroom, one of my least favorite parts of our shop. If you look in here, just like the front of the shop, there's lots of problems with the tile job. Expensive to fix and would put us out of work for who knows how long. All right, we're gonna cruise here through to the back. This is our back entrance and storage room. Right now, it houses some of our biomedical stuff that's awaiting transport, the mop bucket, and the emergency exit. But if you follow me, another area of underutilized space is this beautiful parking lot that no client seems to know is even here. There's no sign on the front or any indication that it even exists. So at the end, do we want to do like, hey, help us?
Yeah, let's do the most cliche thing we can think of.
Help us, Joey Tattoo!